In today's video, I'll be teaching you how to add in a friend bonus system that when your friend joins the game, you will begin to start earning money, as well as your friend. This will happen every 5 seconds, although you can change this number to make it however long you want. For example, if you want it to be every hour, you can do that. Without further ado, let's get right into the tutorial. Let's start off with going into our server script service and creating a leader stats script if you don't already have a leader stats script. If you have this, just bear with me. We'll get to the actual code just in a second. Copy and paste this code from the description below. Once you're done that, you can close out of this and press an arrow to hide that. Next, click on starter player, open this arrow, and then click on starter player scripts. Press on that, and let's add in a local script. Let's rename this script to player is friend. Now let's do is friends with. There we go. And inside of here, let's quickly create a few variables. We're going to need to get our replicated storage. So let's do local RS is equal to game : get service, and then let's just do replicated storage. Okay, that's the only variable that we're going to need. Next, we're going to create a quick while wait loop. While wait 5 do. So let's quickly create a note here, because when you put two of these dashes, then we create a note. So then anything that we type in here won't actually run as a code. So what we can do is let's create a quick note, and let's do wait is in seconds. So this is pretty much in seconds. So however long you want to wait. So this is how long you want to wait until your player gets rewarded. So if every hour you'd probably do about, I think it'll be 3600. I think that's about an hour, if I'm correct. But I'm going to do every 5 seconds, because for demonstration purposes. Okay, so now that we have our wait in for seconds. Also, a quick bonus tip about this is that you can always go to Google and convert seconds into, or convert minutes or hours into seconds. Okay, besides that point, let's create a few variables. Let's go local play. We're going to have to create a local players is going to be equal to game:, we're going to be getting a service, and that service is going to be not package service, but players. There we go. Next, what we're going to do is we're going to go local player is going to be equal to players:localPlayer. So we're going to be needing this players in just a second, but for now we won't actually be needing it. So these are pretty much our variables. The reason we have to put this in a while wait loop is because when a new player joins in, our friend might not be already in the game. So we have to refresh all these variables so that every time this loads, every time we do this while wait loop, it will reload these variables into the new players that are inside of the game. Okay, so I hope that makes sense. Next, we're gonna go ahead and get our players, or our whole players list. So for this, we'll go local children, or let's do lowercase, children are equal to players:getChildren. Now what this will do is we are gonna be getting every player in the game. So let's quickly create a note here, and let's call this gets every player in game. So what we're doing is we're getting all the children. So as you can see, this is like the players list. So since I'm the only one actually inside studios right now, or inside the Roblox studios, it's only going to notice that I'm in the game. Okay, but in a normal like experience, or in a normal game with like 10 people, you'll see the username of all the people. So right now what this is doing is we're just getting the regular players, but the reason we're getting all of the children is we're getting every single player inside the game. And we don't actually have to know the name or anything of the player. So this is super useful. Okay, there we go. Now that I've explained that, we're going to quickly create a if statement. What this if statement is going to do is it's going to go through all the players and check if they're our friends. So we can go a for loop. If for I, child in I pairs, and then we're gonna do children, so we're gonna do for every child within our, so for every child within all the childs. So let's say, like I said, if we have like 10 people in here, we're getting all of them as a group. We are splitting all of these into individual childs that we're gonna check. So we're gonna check every player individually. Okay, and then we're gonna go, and then we're gonna just press enter and should automatically do and end. Okay, and then right here, what we have to do is player, which is our local player, make sure that's lowercase like this, or exactly what you have here, player colon is friends with child, whoops, is friends with child dot user ID. Now user ID probably won't show up, but you're just going to type that up, because right now we don't know what child is. We're pretty much, the game just doesn't know what it is, so we have to tell what the, so we pretty much, we know what the child is. The game yet doesn't know what child is, because we still haven't found child. But it probably won't figure out what children are either. For children, it'll only know that I'm here, so it won't know that anyone else is here. Okay, and then let's do a quick if statement. If player is friends with child, then what we can do is we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna create a variable within our replicated storage, or not a variable, but a remote event. We can rename this to is friends. So this is let's rename this one to found a friend. And so what we can do is if it's found a friend, we can do is let's just enter that. So this is, so every time it's like found a friend inside of here, it will fire this command. So, or this rep, or this remote event. So let's type in RS colon, found a friend colon fire server and then player. No. And then we want to get it off this player because we're firing it from our main player. Okay. This is the whole script that we're going to have to do in here for this to work. Let's quickly create some notes here. So for I is child, this will checks every player. And then right here, if found a friend, fire. We're going to do fires. Oh, I did that wrong. I can't spell fires. The remote event. Okay, so these are just some quick notes. So this is sort of to help you understand what's going on. You don't have to do these, but it's highly recommended so you can understand the code better. Because that's my whole goal here, is to teach you how to code. Okay. So in here, we're going to go ahead and insert one last script. We're going to rename this script to... Let's rename this to give reward. There we go. So now that we're going to give a reward, we're going to go found a friend. So let's quickly go local RS equal to game colon get service and then replicate storage. Then RS dot found a friend dot on serve friend colon connect function. And then let's just type in our player here. There we go. So player dot leader stats dot money dot value plus equal. Let's do 100 like I did previously. And so this is all you have to do. And there we go. That's all the coding that we have to do. And then to check this out, it's actually quite hard. If you have like what I did to check out if this code works is I used like the actual, I have two Roblox on my computer. I have Roblox Player and I have the Roblox website. If you want to test it out, I recommend publishing this one to Roblox and then going in to the actual Roblox with a friend and with someone that you friended and then try it out. And if it doesn't work, you can actually just go into your chat and type in /console and then see what kind of errors popped up. Okay, anyways, I'll see you when I'm in the actual Roblox game. Okay, so I'm right now inside of Roblox Studio with my alt account. And as you can see, our money is going up. So this works. I remade it. This is not the same one as previously. So thanks for watching. If this video helped you out, make sure to subscribe. Like I said, you can always change the value of how fast this goes up. We are almost at 50 subscribers. This is absolutely incredible. Yeah, thanks so much for subscribing. Hopefully this video helped you out, and hopefully I taught you something about some code. So, yeah, see you.